and we are the co-founders of Cards for a Cause. So to tell you a little bit about Cards for a Cause, it's an initiative we both sort of came up with during the lockdown a few months ago. It is essentially a deck of playing cards. Each card is uniquely designed around the theme of the pandemic by over 55 different artists who collaborated in this effort and who came together to design unique cards and unique artworks around the theme and around their feelings and thoughts about the pandemic. After which we sort of packaged it and designed a whole identity for it and sort of put it out to in the market, and of which money is to go for a good cause.
So basically the idea came to us back in May, when this was a period when the lockdown had just started, and it was a very gloomy atmosphere, and both of us, like, we used to share artworks with each other on Instagram, and we were like, this is so good, like, this is genuinely making my day better. And that's when I was playing a game of flashcards with my niece. Like, she's a 3-year-old, like, little child, and the idea came to me during that what if we actually create artworks that are for a cause, and it's also into a game. Like, people were anyway sitting at home during this period, so what if someone gets to sit with their family and have a good game and they donate for a cause?
So I think once we had the idea in place, it was very important to translate it into, you know, like a product by itself. Once we thought about it, we sort of went back and figured out a list of different people who we'd want to speak to, how we'd want to sell it, where we'd want to sell it, you know, the product itself, the quality of the product. So there were a lot of things to sort of think through. And eventually, I think 2 months later, the product hit the market.
So there are 5 things that play into a collaboration. So initially when we started the project, there were already a lot of artists that we used to follow and we had admired that work for a very, very long time, and we always wanted to create something with them. So we put down these names together, and as and when we started discovering more artists as well, so we talked to all of these artists and we sent them, like, we didn't know any of these artists personally or anything, we just used to follow them on Instagram. We sent them a very personalized message saying that because we anyway followed these artists for a long time, we know the kind of style that they had and the kind of artworks and the things that they were passionate about. So we pointed these out to them and we told them that we have admired your work for a very long time and this is our idea, we want to do something for a cause, and would you be able to help us with that, would you be able to donate an artwork with that. We were very clear during that point that this was a collaboration.
Building on to what she's already shared, collaborations and the entire effort brought with it a lot of different, a lot of different learnings that came out of it. I think one of the most important things that we learned during the process was, especially because these were contributions done by artists, we thought it was very important, and it is always very important to, you know, give each artist their due credit, because today we are speaking for them, the product is speaking for them, but it is ideally their hard work, it is their it's their piece of art which is going out to so many homes and is reaching out and, you know, building a connect with so many different people. So credit was a very big thing for us.
We had a plus point there. We were already starting off with an account that had a considerable good amount of following. Like, we had the page that we run, which is called the Artlet Poetry, It had 30,000 followers to begin with, so that was a good place for us to ask someone a favor. But again, whenever we posted each and every artwork, we were very open to telling our audience that these artists have contributed their artwork, and it would mean the world to us if you could go and show them support on their own pages. Like, you give them a follow, visit their website, whichever platforms they are present on.
So the idea, I think, was to generally make everybody benefit from the whole exercise and, you know, give them their due credit, which is especially important in collaborations.
So initially, like when we started, we had thought that every 55, all of the numbers would go with each artwork and we would randomly assign that. But when we started receiving the artworks, we realized that there are certain numbers which would go very well with a particular card number. So that's how we started rearranging the assignments. And that's also, there was one particular request that we had gotten from this artist called Radhika Sivsankar, and she wanted a two of hearts for an artwork. We had one more who requested an artwork for a number 3 because they wanted to talk about the Powerpuff Girl. These were the changes that we realized during the process of making these artworks and taking in the submissions. And That's what makes the deck so unique, because each artwork is on a different theme of isolation and pandemic.
And like, it's also very detailed, you know, like we tend to miss, like generally when somebody's going through the entire artwork, the level of detailing and the thought, even with the number correlating with the artwork, is a small detail, but it really adds a nice feeling towards the end of the whole activity. So that was very important. I think additionally, the last point that we wanted to cover here was the importance of the relationships that we built throughout the whole process. It was magical because these were illustrators who we had seen, who we had, you know, been following, and then eventually, like, having to work with them, building a relationship, accommodating for them, them accommodating for us, is a relationship which is eventually, I think, something which you cherish for a lifetime. So any collaboration, however short it is always, is always
like a
something
stepping
which
stone into a
yeah. It's ideally like a stepping stone into a longer association, which as of now also, like, we have a lot of branding projects we do, or a lot of other kinds of activities which we do, which where we sort of go back to these artists and, you know, ask to collaborate, or ask to, you know, like, let's design this together, or let's do this together. So it's very important to nurture these relationships, be very careful of, you know, what and how we deal with these relationships. So I think that was a very, very big learning.
True.
And we're very blessed to have worked with 55 such wonderful
and we're so glad they were so enthusiastic
and accommodating.
And that's how creative collaboration works in general. Like, if you're approaching someone, you do it with an open heart. You tell them what your project is about. Also, be very clear about your expectations, that what do you aim to get from this project and how is it going to benefit the other person. Be clear about the deadlines. Be clear about accommodating their request.
I think all just harvests a really, really healthy relationship.
That's true.
And that's the foundation of every great collaboration.
And we're so thankful. Like, we've already sold more than 500 decks, and we have donated 5,000 meals, and like all these cards are going to different places all over India, and we are getting so many heartfelt, nice messages. So
yes, very, very nice messages coming from people who are, you know, appreciating the artworks, and it's just a very nice feeling to have done this. And I think, I hope collaborations in the creative space work for all of you. The wackiest of ideas are the best ones, so we hope you also experiment with your own creative collaboration, and I hope this little talk helped as well.
Bye.